What's up, my beautiful people? Welcome back to the channel. I'm gonna be screaming really loud. We're outside, it's very windy. I wanna make sure the mic picks up my voice well, even with the wind in the background. But this is a run update. We haven't done one in a long time. And we ran over 3,000 miles in 84 days. So let's talk about pace. It's been very difficult for me to go back to my normal pace, and I'm still not there yet. Even after the Transcontinental, running a 9-minute mile pace felt like it was impossible, y'all. And I had to literally be patient with myself and tell myself, hey, like, you just ran 3,000 miles, which it usually takes a year for you to do that. You did that in 84 days, so be patient with yourself. You'll eventually get there. But guess what, y'all? We are making progress. I'm making progress. I'm so happy for myself. I've been running in the sub-8-minute mile pace comfortably now, high 7 minutes. And when I do 8, it almost feels like I'm not even trying, which is great. This run you guys are seeing right now, I actually did 6 miles. The last miles, my pace was at 6:51 and I finished at 7:04 because they got windy. But the overall pace was 7:42. I am loving it. And I wanna run 5,000 miles this year, y'all. That's the goal. I've done it before between May of 2020 to May of 2021, because I was in the middle of Transcontinental. I did complete 5,000 miles in a year span, but I wanna do it for 2021, do 5,000 miles. That's the goal. But after this year, y'all, I hella serious, I promise y'all, I'm gonna bring another level of hard work, another level of running that I've never done in my life to you guys, to show you we can always progress in different ways in running. There's so many variations of it. I'm gonna run level 100. I wanna do so many marathon races because I wanna see what I can do for myself again, even though I've tried those in the past besides level 100. All right, next one we're gonna talk about, being mindful with running. I really have to remind myself that, and the mindset of running, and don't let running be a chore. It is not a chore, y'all. It is not a chore. Remember that. There might be pressure from society, pressure from teammates, friends, whatever you're doing with running. Don't make it a chore, because at the end of the day, it's not something that you gotta do. Even myself, with more eyes on me right now, I always remind myself I do this because I wanna do it. I'm enjoying it. It's not what other people are putting pressure on me. So instead of me saying I gotta go run, I don't say that. I switch the word got to get. I get to go run. It's a privilege to go run. It's not I gotta go run. So when you're telling yourself you gotta go run, don't say that, say I get to go run, because you get the opportunity to get to go run. So be mindful about that and don't let any society pressure make it a chore. It's not a chore, have fun with it. Yes, it's important to work hard. Yes, it's important to get after it every single day, no matter the circumstances, whatever that may be for you. But at the end of the day, have fun with it, y'all. So my body weight, what do you guys think? Does it look like I put on some mass? Look at this, I feel like the quad is coming back. It doesn't feel like it's depleted, but I'm getting my weight back. I'm getting stronger, I'm getting comfortable, and I'm reminding myself that I can be strong and be a strong runner. So if you feel like you're not the way that you wanna be, that is okay. Progress, progression. I'm getting my weight back, I'm feeling healthy. I look healthy, I feel healthy. It's not even about looking healthy, but feeling healthy. I feel stronger, I feel like my powers are coming back in my legs. So the way progress is going really well. Let me know what you guys think, guys. You know, sometimes it feels good to feel good. Not just sometimes, actually all the time. What am I talking about? I'm so excited, I don't even know what to say. What else do we got next? Strava, shout out to my Strava family, y'all. I love communicating with you guys. I love sharing all my little ups and downs with you guys, sharing the progress. And the Hella Good Run Club is going crazy. We have over 1,500 runners. And thank you guys for getting me 20,000 followers on Strava. It's amazing. It's the running community on Strava is unreal. It's so positive. I appreciate you guys. I love you guys. And I've been running with both watches, Apple Watch and Garmin. I've had a dilemma with the Fenix 6 Pro. Go look at my last YouTube video. You'll see what I mean by that. And we might get Coros, guys. What do you think about Coros watch? I want to check that out as well. And for running shoes, yes, right now I have Hoka on. Actually, I'm matching, guys. Check this out. It's a fall color. Shout out to Gymshark. Fall orange. But I've been running with different shoes, every kind of shoes this year. This is the biggest thing I've ever done. I'm always alternating. Like every day I'm alternating with something else, or every other day. And I feel like it's making me feel, even the little aches and pain I used to get a few years ago, I don't get that anymore, because I'm changing the shoes. I'm letting the shoes heal overnight and not putting that much miles on it back to back. So which is cool as well. And I cannot wait. Come 2022, the Hella Good Run Club is coming near you, to your city. I'm gonna find you guys wherever you're at, and we're gonna meet together and run. I wanna make that happen. That's one of my goals, besides the running goals itself, like races and things like that. But I wanna meet you guys so we can run together, y'all. I think it'll be incredible to meet you guys and see your story and hear your story and go to your hood so we get that run in. For everyone that has goals that they wanna accomplish, okay? Even for 2022, let's not wait for 2022. Let's take the necessary step today, little by little, okay? Tomorrow isn't promised, 2022 isn't promised, but don't live in a fear also saying, oh, tomorrow isn't promised, let me freak out right now. But what I wanna say is, take that step. I'm getting ready for my goals next year by living in the present moment and making progress, being a little bit stronger, getting my pace up to go faster again, following attention to my paying attention to my body, paying attention to the details, and making myself not just physically better, but mentally better, and enjoying life, enjoying life. There's so many stuff happening around us that gets us consumed and gets us in this area and deep spot, and we want to get away from it. Just remember that life is beautiful. Remind yourself that you matter. Remind yourself that you can make your dreams a reality. Remind yourself that you can do something that makes you happy every single day. Welcome back to another run update. I'm so happy to update you guys because it's been a minute. Let me know what you got planned for 2022 and what you're doing about it today. I love you guys. Thank you for watching. See you guys in the next video. Let's get it. Let's go. Woo!